Good morning, students. Today we are discussing about the basic concepts of semiconductor physics. So anyone have the idea about the classification of materials? Anyone? Yeah, I'll discuss now. So generally the solids can be classified into the conductors, insulators and semiconductors. So what do you mean by conductors? Which allows the current. What do you mean by insulators? Which obstruct the flow of current. So what is a semiconductor? So there is a partial passage of current. So this type of materials are said to be the semiconductor materials. So if you look at the resistivity of a particular semiconducting material, so look at this here. The resistivity of metals are given in the order of 10^-8, and the conductivity is in the order of 10^-7. If you look at the alloys, it is order of 10^-7. When it comes to the nickel, 10^-6. So let me come to the insulators. The resistivity is order of 10^-11, 10^-13, 10^-14. If you look at the quartz, 10^-7. So based on the resistivity, so I'm defining with respect to the resistivity like semiconductors. The carbon resistivity is order of -5, 10^-5. And germanium and silicon, the resistivity 0.46 and 640. So based on the resistivity, so I can define the semiconductors are having the poor resistivity value. So in that, let us go for the silicon. Silicon atomic density is 5 to 10^22 atoms per centimeter cube. So silicon having the 4 electrons here, so it forms the covalent bond here. When the temperature increase, so what happens? There is a possibility of breakage of covalent bonds. So due to the breakage, bond breakage, there is a generation of electron and hole pair. So let us look at this figure. So there is a covalent bond. When the temperature increase, there is a breakage of the bond. One electron is created as well as a hole is created. This electron is ready to move in a crystal lattice point. So the pure silicon having the higher electrical resistivity at room temperature. In general, when the temperature is applied, there is a breakage of bond. There are two types of mobile charge carriers. One is electrons, other is due to the holes. So I'm assuming electrons are the negatively charged particles, whereas holes are the positive charged particles. So the concentration of conductive electrons and holes in a semiconductor can be modulated in several ways. That means I want to increase the more number of electrons or more number of holes. This can be modulated by certain ways. The first one is, let us go for the dopant. So I am giving more number of impurity to the crystal lattice point so that I am generating the more number of electrons. This is one way. Otherwise, apply the larger electric field so that I can break the bonds. Otherwise, apply the maximum temperature. So thermal energy ready to ENF break the covalent bonds between the silicon and silicon. So electron and holes are generated. So by other ways, by apply the more radiation. So with respect to this particular concepts, with respect to this particular factors, we can generate more of electrons and holes. So let us look at this. When a conduction electron is thermally generated, at the same time hole is also generated. Here I am assuming the electron is there within the this hole, within the vacancy. When the electron is left out, so I am creating a positive hole. So I am assuming the empty cavity considered as a hole, which is a positive value. So like this electron moving here, so this somewhere there is a breakage of bond, this electron will occupy this particular hole, there is a hole is created. Like this, the hole is created throughout the complete crystal lattice. So we can assume that the hole is moving from here and here. So the highest energy band completely filled electrons is called as a valency band. So this particular portion is said to be the valency band. So if there is any electron left it out, or just generally we can say that the top of the valency band is said to be the conduction band. So the valency band is nothing but completely filled electron shells are set to be the valency band. So above the valency band is nothing but an empty band, is called as a conduction band. The difference between the valency band and the conduction band is defined as energy gap. The unit of energy gap is 1.5, is for silicon points 1.1 electron volts, whereas the germanium is 0.76 electron volts. So here the whole conduction is a positive charged particles, where electron is said to be the negative charged particles. So if you look at the summary of charge carriers with respect to this, we can break the covalent bonds, we can generate the electron and hole. So that hole, if it's a more number of holes are there, that is the p-type, or if it is a more number of electrons are there, so you can say that n-type. So here, if I dope any trivalent impurity here, so I can generate more number of holes, that is set with the p-type. This trivalent impurity, nothing but the trivalent, so that it is said to be the p-type material, which is the more number of holes, and it is said to be the acceptors. If I dope the fifth group element like a phosphorus, so one electron is free, so that four electrons silicon is having, the phosphorus having five electrons, among the five electrons, the four electrons are paired up with the silicon, so one more electron left, so that electron is ready to move in a crystal lattice, so that it is said to be the n-type material. So this electron is called as a donor electrons. So in the n-type material, they are said to be the donor electrons, whereas in the case of p-type, they are said to be the major minority numbers or holes, it is said to be the acceptors. So this is about the summary of the charge carriers which you have studied in the intermediate. Now let me look at intrinsic semiconductor. This is a valency band, this is a conduction band. This is the maximum of the valency band, this is the minimum of the conduction band. So that is at room temperature, let me say T is equal to 0 Kelvin. There is no electrons available in the conduction band. So what happens if increase the temperature, there is a possibility of breakage of the bonds, so that any electron may come and occupy the conduction band. So what happens, the electron is moving here, there is a holes are created here. So let us calculate how many number of electrons are available in the conduction band. So let us, at the same time, we can calculate number of holes are created in the valency band. If you look at the qualitative analysis of this, so I can calculate how many number of density of states available in the conduction band, how many number of ways I can accommodate the electrons in the density of states. So there is a certain statistical approach. From this, we can calculate the number of electrons available in the conduction band. So where NC is set to the pseudo constant, so EC is the conduction band, EF is the Fermi level. So if you look at clearly, so that what happens, the Fermi level, the position is exactly at here, is it here, so that the electrons are moving from here to here, the Fermi level position will be here. So similarly, I can calculate the possibility of number of electrons plus possibility of number of holes is equal to 1. So based on that, I can assess how many number of holes are created in the valency band. So in this case, you may get the same statistical approach. You can calculate. So it comes to be NV into exponential minus EF minus EV by KBT. This is the number of holes. If you equate the number of holes and number of electrons, you get to know about the Fermi level position. So with respect to the figure, you can assess that if there is a number of electrons are the same, then let me say there are four electrons, there are four holes, the Fermi level position exactly lies at the center. So what is the Fermi level? The Fermi level indicates the probability of finding the majority number of charge carriers. In the case of conduction band, four electrons are available. In the case of valency band, there are four holes are available. So there is a neutral of charges, so that you can say that the Fermi level exactly lies at the center. Let us prove with respect to the mathematical analysis. Number of holes is equal to number of electrons. If you equate more this thing, so that you can use to get to get the Fermi level position is equal to EC plus EV by 2. So the Fermi level lies exactly at the center. So in the case of intrinsic carrier concentration, there's a mass action law, number of density of the conduction electrons in the conduction band, the number of holes in the valency band, if you multiply, you'll get the intrinsic carrier concentration. So the intrinsic carrier concentration is directly proportional to the exponential of minus EG by 2 KBT. That depends upon the temperature factor. So in the case of intrinsic semiconductor at greater than 200 Kelvin, the conductivity is due to the number of electrons, so number of holes. This is only the mathematical expression. So as increase in temperature, what happens, the Fermi level position is going to be shift upwards or downwards. If more number of holes are available in the valency band, the Fermi level shifts downwards. If more number of electrons available in the conduction band, it moves in the upward direction. The doping is nothing but incorporation of impurities into the semiconductor crystal. It is said to be the doping. So doping can be done based on the atomic sites available in the material. We cannot just like dope more number of electrons material into the system. So the extrinsic semiconductor nothing but which can be doped with respect to the impurities, either interstitial or substitutional. So just now we discussed about the n-type material. We are doping the fifth group element into the system so that the extra electron is generated. So these extra electrons are responsible for the conduction. So in the case of more electrons available, so this line is said to be the donor level where the electrons are available. So when increase the temperature, so this donor electrons are going to occupy the conduction band, so that the probability of charge carriers appears only in the conduction band, so that the extrinsic Fermi level exactly lies at the center. So like this, we are trying to do the mathematical analysis. The number of density of states available in the conduction band is equal to the number of electrons available at the donor level. If you equate, you still get the Fermi level position. So the Fermi level position lies exactly at the EC plus ED by 2. So like in the previous case, intrinsic semiconductor, the Watt procedure you have adopted, if you do the same process, you still get the Fermi level lies exactly at the center. So the same approach if you follow for the p-type material. So you can see that the more number of holes are available at the valency band, so this is set to the acceptor level. So the acceptor level says that which it can take the electron which is coming from the valency band. So the number of holes are created in the valency level. So once electron jumps here, so there is a holes are created. So you can guess the Fermi level position now. So in the previously n-type material, the Fermi level near to the conduction band. In the case of p-type material, so the Fermi level lies near to the valency band. So this line is said to be the acceptor energy level, whereas this line is said to be the valency band. So the Fermi level position is, we can guess EV plus EA by 2. So finally you used to get the Fermi level position is EV plus EA by 2. So I'm concluding now. So in the case of intrinsic semiconductor, the Fermi level lies exactly at the center. In the case of p-type material, the Fermi level lies near to the valency band. If you consider n-type material, the Fermi level lies near to the conduction band. Like in the case of n-type, EC plus ED by 2, the Fermi level position. So in the case of valency band, EV plus EA by 2. So we'll follow up the next concepts in the next class. So, thank you.